Okay, first and foremost, I want to give all honors and praises and glory belongs to my Lord and Savior, whose name is Yahweh, Bahasham, Yahawashai, Bahasham, Wahavaka Kodash. The name of the Heavenly Father is Yahweh, and his Son's name is Yahawashai, in whom we reverence and honors to the elder apostles of Great Millstone that taught me this truth, and to the hopeful elect across the globe, and to the few, the very few, brothers and sisters listening and also learning in the hopes of being saved within these last days. And I want to say to Wadi Yahawa, to Wadi Yahabai Shem, Yahawa Shem, to Wadi Yahawa, to Wadi Yahawa, by Shem, Yahawashai, for giving me another day to minister. Because this is not of my own accord. It's Yahawashai that gives me the strength to push this word. Continue to have faith. And Lord willing, this will be edifying. And we're going to start off on Isaiah. Right? This is Isaiah 62. And let's go straight to 6. I have set watchmen. So the watchmen in the ancient days, they'd be watching over the tower. You know? You'd have that high tower, the castle, and you'd have what? Them high towers within that castle. You'd be guarding what? The city. And that word for watchmen is Nadzah. Nadzah. Watchmen. To guard with fidelity, to guard from dangers, to warn you. So the prophets, they were also known as watchmen, right? They'll watch out for the affairs that would be happening, okay? If an enemy's coming in, why are they coming in, right? Danger, okay? And that's what the prophets are warning you of today, okay? Right, yes, sir, yes, sir. And 6. I've set watchmen upon thy walls, O Jerusalem, who shall never hold their peace, day nor night. So the prophets, they were not going to be quiet. They were going to continue to speak, right? They were going to continue to prophesy. They were going to continue to what? To watch. For what? For the signs. And as many signs, as many things that are happening. Look at the tensions. Russia, Ukraine. This is all a part of prophecy, right? You had a couple hours ago, you had the Prime Minister of Ukraine saying, we're not gonna invade Russia. So they're bold. It's not, they're very bold, Ukraine. You would think they'd say the opposite. But that's what the PM said, the Ukraine PM. We're not going to, we don't intend, paraphrasing, on invading Russia. So that means when the times are necessary, they're willing to go to war, right? They're more than willing to go to war, okay, with Russia, okay? All these nations are getting what? Ready. And it says, I set watchmen upon their walls, O Jerusalem, and me are those spiritual watchmen, warning you, guarding the city with fidelity. They shall not hold their peace day nor night. So the elect, they're going to continually be crying out to Yahawashai. They were not going to be holding their peace. They were not going to be keeping silent. They were not going to be going multiple days on end without doing anything. Right? And it says, mention of the Lord, keep not silent. So we can't keep silent. A true watchman ain't going to keep silent. Right? It's going to be all throughout the day. They're going to make an effort to bring up, whether it's prophecy, whether it's wisdom, they're going to make an effort. But it's all going to be pertaining to what? The downfall of this kingdom. Right? You have to stay occupied in what? In this truth. Right? because it's so easy to get distracted from the things that are going on around us. It's so easy, right? Always keep on the forefront of our minds that Yahweh Shai is coming back. That's what keeps us going, right? And it says that make mention of the Lord, keep not silent. So no, we can't keep silence. We have to continue to cry out. We have to continue to make our voice known to Yahweh Shai. Make them supplications, right? And now we're going to go to Luke. Before we go to Luke, let's go to Matthew's. I believe it's 24, because I ain't been in this script for a long time. Barely just a minute. This is Matthew 24, right? This is Matthew 24. And we go straight to 32. Now learn a parable. A parable is a dark saying, right? And this is learning. So within these parables, there's wisdom, right? Of the fig tree, right? When he branches yet tender and put it forth leaves, you know that summer is night. So that means this even shows you figs. They start to bloom, they start to bud just before summer, right? So the fig trees right now, and maybe this is parabolic, it's spiritual, but it shows you the fig trees are blooming in what? Winter, okay? And what? The fruit comes at summer. So it's the same with what these prophecies, bear me just a minute. And it says, so likewise, ye, when you shall see all these things, what things? The prophecies, right? The what? The wars of rumors, Ukraine, Russia, right? Hurricanes, tornadoes. Look what happened at the end of 2020. There was major tornadoes, major earthquakes, volcanoes, Italy, Spain. Look how long that volcano was going on for. We can't forget these things. These were all signs, right? So every day, there's prophecy playing out, okay? Every single day. And it says, wait just a minute. Ye likewise, ye, when you shall see all these things, know that it is near, even at the doors. So when we're seeing these things pop off, we're knowing Yahweh Shai's return is there. It's not far off, right? And yet it should get us excited. We should be excited, right? But it's near, even at the doors. So it's suffix at the door, it's approaching at the doors. Verily I say unto you, this generation shall not pass till all these things be fulfilled. So this current generation we're living in, it's not going to pass till these prophecies are fulfilled. Right? And that's exactly what we're waiting for. To see all these things. Okay? And how do we know that? Let's quickly go to Ecclesiastes. Bear me some minutes. One and four, I believe it is. One and four. This is one and four. One generation passeth away. So you got generations that come and go. And another generation cometh. But the earth abideth forever. Right? So this is, again, it's the same generation that was back there 2,000 years ago. And back here again today. Some to receive salvation, some to receive destruction, right? But it says the earth is going to abide forever. The earth ain't going nowhere, but there's going to be particular spots on earth that are going to be hit. But the earth remains. Why? Because the earth is what? To be dwelt in. Okay? In righteousness. We're going to go back to where we were. We're back on Matthew 24. and 35. Heaven and earth shall pass away. This is referring to the rulership. Okay, Esau's rulership, that's gonna pass away. That's gonna be done away with, right? But, bear me just a minute. But my words shall not pass away. Let's go to Isaiah 55. A minute, these words are not going to pass away. Every prophecy within these scriptures is going to play out, right? And that's what we believe in. This is our hope. All right, this is Isaiah 55. And start at 10. For as the rain cometh down, and the snow from heaven, and returneth not thither, but watereth the earth, and maketh it bring forth and bud, that it may give seed to the sower and bread to the eater, right? So shall my word be that goeth forth out of my mouth, right? So this word that we're speaking, that's going forth, it's going to play out, right? It's not going to go forth vain, as a vain thing. It shall not return unto me void. In other words, it's empty, right? But it shall accomplish that which I please. So this word, it's accomplishing. It's achieving where it needs to go, right? It's working its work, right? But it shall accomplish that which I please. It shall prosper in the thing whereto I sent it. So this word, don't, for 1 minute, don't think, all right, you're teaching this word, but nothing's really happening. No, this word is accomplishing its purpose, where it needs to go. It's being sent where it needs to go. The elect are hearing it, and the elect are being woken up. All right? Even the elites are hearing this, and they're being condemned. So this word is going out. All we do is just push that energy, that vibration out there, that righteous vibration, to the best of our ability. Okay? Go back on Matthew's. This is Matthew 24 and 36. But of the day and hour knoweth no man. Because a lot of people ask us and say, well, when is he going to come back? People that don't believe, they say, well, they've been saying this for years. How's it going to happen now? You've been saying this for a long time. Okay. We believe it because it's faith. That's why we believe, right? We believe in these prophecies. And first, we have faith. And it takes faith to believe in these things. These things are going to come, right? And it says, but of the day and hour knoweth no man, right? We don't know the hour, and neither know we know the day. We don't know, but one thing we do know, that Yahushua, he's going to make his return. Yahushua is coming back, right? And he's coming back with great wrath. Okay. Know not the angels, but my Father only. Knoweth no man. So if anybody gives you a particular time and say he's coming back on this time, January 2000 and something something, if that don't happen, that individual's a false prophet. We don't put a date and we don't put a time, but we have expectations that Yahushua is coming back. And that's it, right? Neither man knows the time, neither the angels. We don't know. That's why we watch, because guess what? If our people did know, they'd be what? Doing a whole bunch of wickedness. And at that particular moment, that particular time, that they would know Yahushua to come back, that's when they would get right. Okay? That's why it was set up that particular way. Because remember, Jacob is a supplanter, right? And our people, they were trying to what? Supplant salvation. Right? And that's why this thing, yeah, it is about faith and works. It is about faith and works. Right? Your belief in Yahweh Shai. And with that belief, you're going to have a certain amount of works. Yeah, we know you're going to get some that come in the last hour. But the last hour, that was them. But those that know they've had a calling, what are they going to do? They're going to make their what they're calling an election. Sure, because we're not 100% of the elect. So what do? We make that calling an election sure, so we may be saved. Right? But my Father only the Heavenly Father knows the time, the appointed time. Okay? He knows the appointed time when Babylon's going to be destroyed and when Yahweh is going to make his return. Right? But as the days of Noah were, so shall also the coming Son of Man be. So what was happening in the days of Noah? Right? People were eating, drinking, in mirth, having fun, reveling. For as in the days that were before the flood, right? For as the days that were before the flood, right? They were eating, right? And drinking, right? So they were eating, drinking, not really caring. Okay? Not really caring. Just going about with their everyday life. Just like the people are today. The people, they're not really concerned. As long as they can make a bit of money, rest their head, lay down with their woman, watch Netflix, they're fine. But we know there's more to life than that. We know that, right? And eating and drinking and marrying and giving in marriage. So this is what was happening back then in the time of Noah. People were preoccupied on pleasing the flesh. How do we know? Because it tells us, right? Until the day Noah entered into the ark, right? And he lets us know until that day he entered into the ark, right? Then it was too late. That's when they wanted to get right. So it's going to be the same thing with us, right? And it says, and knew not until the flood came and took them all away. All of a sudden, it says they knew not, right? Until the flood came. But still, Noah was still warning them. But they knew not. Why? Because even Noah, he didn't even have a time. Oh, that's heavy. Even Noah, he didn't even have a day or time. Right? Noah didn't even have a particular day or time. But he was warning the people. Look, there's a flood. There's a flood that's going to happen. Get right, repent. Come back to Yahweh, I'm ashamed. Right? And that flood is going to be what the danger. Right? The calamity. And that flood's going to be a flood of fire upon this earth. And you know, until the flood came and took them all away. All, except from Noah and the eight souls that were with him and those souls of the animals that were in the ark. Right? So right now we're telling you, get in this ark. Right now, this is an ark. This is the covering from that danger. From that fire. This truth. Right? And it says, so shall the coming of the Son of Man be. Right? When shall two be in the field? The one taken and the other left. So, what's going to be taken in them chariots? And that's what we want. That's what we're fighting for. Right? Salvation. Right? And the other shall be left, the other's going to be left to destruction. Right? And I don't want to be left here to be destruction, I want to be delivered. Right? two women shall be grinding at a mill, and one shall be taken and the other left. Watch therefore, for you know not what hour your Lord hath come. So these are warnings for us to watch, because we don't know what hour Yahweh is going to come. So we stay preoccupied within this truth. You have to. If you don't, the world's going to what? Take you by surprise. Revelation, it talks about, blessed is he that what? Has his garment. Keep with his garment. Lest he be what? Found to walk naked. Paraphrasing. And what? They see his shame. Because without the garment, not this, it's not talking about this garment, without a spiritual garment, others what? Will see your shame. Right? So that's why we got to stay occupied on this truth. Okay? Continually. You alright? And where was I there? Just a minute. But who then is a wise and faithful servant whose Lord made ruler of his household to give them meat in due time? So if we have to stay watching, we have to stay occupied. Right? On the scriptures. Right? Bear me just a minute. Oh man. Very, very heavy times we're in. Very heavy times. Let's go to Amos 8. Right? How about this is Amos 8. And let's start straight at 11. Behold, the days come. Right? Saith the Lord Yahweh Shai, power, but I will send a famine in the land. Right? So it lets us know it's going to be a famine in the land. And in that time, there is going to be a famine of bread, but it's right now they say, speaking upon that. Right? Not a thirst for water, but a hearing of the words of the Lord Yahweh, why Yahweh Shai. Right? So what does that mean? That means the men of the Lord, they're not going to be accessible like they are now, right? Not going to be easily accessible, right? And the internet is only going to be granted to those that have that chip. So the men of the Lord, they're going to be completely hidden. And a lot of our videos are going to be taken off YouTube. You ain't going to see us out here anymore, right? This is what time we are approaching. That's why if you're watching these videos and you're not doing anything, you have to take it seriously. You have to take this seriously. Because it's going to be a time where we're not out here, where our videos are no longer going to be up there. It's going to be a time, right? Because even with the chip, which we can go into, for you to have access to these particular things and activities, you will need to have the chip. So everything's going to be done by that one little chip. All controlling, all access is going to be done by that chip. Right? And yes, this is what time we are in. Okay? So there is going to be a famine of the word. And that's why you got to give it your all. The last thing I want to be is in that spirit of, I wish I should have, could have. I wish I could have done more. That's the last place I want to be. I want to know I've done everything, everything. I gave it my all, everything. Because if you don't, your conscience is going to condemn you. Right? And it says, and they shall wander from sea to sea. In other words, from place to place, right? From the north, even to the east, right? From different lands, okay? to seek the word of the Lord, Jabashai shall not find it. So it ain't gonna be easily accessible, right? And shall not find it. So why are they not gonna find it? Because the men of the Lord are not gonna be there. So really, don't take this truth for granted. That's all I'm saying. Do not take this truth for granted. Every day, and it starts now, right? All right, you've received this word now, well, do something about that, right? Use what you've been given. You've been given a talent, use that talent. Because in that time, you will appreciate it if you were really what sincere, right? And you got more of our people that are not sincere than those that are really are sincere, right? And it says, where was I? And they shall what? Run to seek the word of the Lord, and they shall not find it. So a lot of people, they're not going to find the word. They're going to be seeking it, but they're not going to find it. Because when that opportunity was there, you didn't take it. Right? This is deadly serious. It's going to be more pain. There's going to be more anguish. There's going to be more rioting. Right? It's going to be more with food, certain food in the store. It's going to be a shortage. All that's going to happen on a big way. Just look how people were acting when there wasn't much petrol. Look how people were acting. Look how people were acting when the pandemic first started. Huh? You have people what stuffing their trolleys. Just being selfish, taking all the toilet paper, the water. All that's going to happen again on a very, very large scale. The same thing, right? So we got to be equipped with this knowledge, aware, not getting caught out with the things of this world. And that's where I really wanted to go into as well, because I know brothers are being distracted. It even happens with me, entertainment, all these different things, right? Let's go to Ecclesiastes. And we go to Luke as well, maybe just a minute. It's so easy to get caught up on the things of the world. Entertainment, and entertainment is a distraction. And obviously we do things to balance out our time, obviously, because you need to, or you just bug out, you just turn mad. But always remember, whatever you're doing, always remember this truth. Even when you're watching a movie, whatever you're doing, you may be pumping weights. Always think about this truth. Right? Because if you don't, you can tend to get distracted by the things of this world. Okay? And then it's harder to get back on track. And I know brothers are dealing with that. So, Lord willing, this would be exhortational. Right? Let's go to Ecclesiastes 7. And let's jump straight to... Start at 2. It is better to go into the house of mourning. So the hopeful elect, that's where they were going to be. More so in the house of mourning. Right? Frustrated with the way things are in this world. Right? And when you're mourning, you're not happy. Right? Learn to go into the house of feasting. So right now, this truth is the house of mourning. Right? Not feasting. Not, and feasting represents what? The world. Right? For that is the end of all men. So the house of feasting... Yes, it's the end of all men. Because then you're not contrite. Right? And the living will lay it to his heart. Right? So the living are going to lay this to mind. They're not going to be in a serious mind state. The house of mourning is a serious mind state. Right? Very serious. You're reflecting. When you're reading the scriptures, when you're reading 2 Peter 3 and 10, you're reflecting on that fire that's going to burn up this earth. Right? And yeah, a lot of our loved ones may not make it. But we've got to have tunnel vision in this truth. Really focus, really zone in what's about to happen. Right? For that is the end of all men. The house of feasting is the end. Really, that leads to death. Because it, what, that... ties in with the flesh. The house of feasting represents what? Flesh. which remember, we do things to balance out our time. But we don't always want to be in that perpetual state of what? Feeding the flesh. Okay? And the living will lay it to his heart. So if you're living, if you're woken by this truth, you're going to lay this, these sayings to mind. And be like, you know what? Yeah, I've got to really tap into the spirit to the best of my ability. That's what I'm making an effort to do. Because it does get hard. Things can get hard from time to time. Right? But if you've got your Habesha on your side, that's beautiful. Okay, you're going to endure if you have your Habesha on your side. Right? And it says, sorrow is better than laughter. Most of these people, they're not sorrowful. They're in laughter, right? And the reason why they're in that state, because they don't want to deal with reality. A lot of men, they don't want to deal with the reality of these scriptures, what's coming upon the earth. So they're in the what? The state of laughter. And a lot of people, when they laugh, it's like a fake laugh, a pretentious fake laugh. And really, they don't really feel like that, but it's to hide the pain, right? Because really, these people, somewhat, they know something ain't right, but remember, they're a girl of the world, right? And it says, the soul is better than laughter. So it's actually better. Because sorrow leads to being the contrary. That's why it says sorrow is better than laughter. Because you're contrite. You're reflective. Right? You're penitent when you're sorrowful. Right? By the sadness of the countenance, the heart is made better. In other words, our mind. So yeah, our minds are made better through sorrow. Not through laughter, not through giddiness. Not through mirth. Your heart ain't made better. Your flesh maybe, but not your heart. Because after all that fun, who are you really? Just like with these entertainers that do a concert. After that concert, who are they? When everybody ain't praising them. When the doors are closed. Right? And it says, the heart is made better. Your mind is made better. Right? And it says, the heart of the wise is in the house of mourning. Right? So a wise mind is going to be in the house of what? Mourning. Right? Serious. Not joking about. Not coming to camp on Saturday and just turning up. Because anybody can do that. Right? Just turn up. Just go for the motions. Right? But the heart of fools is in the house of mirth. So it lets us know the heart of fools should be in a house of mirth and would be what? Preoccupied on mirth. Not the important matters or the important issues of this world. And you have a shy what coming back. Right? And it says the heart of what? The heart of the wise in the house of mourning, but the heart of fools in the house of mirth. It is better to hear the rebuke of the wise, right? It's better to get cursed out by another man, oft in the truth, okay, for a man to hear the song of fools, okay? Because what, you're serious, right? The Satan's going to continually be setting up different distractions. Okay, to try and throw you off the truth. But you have to keep going. Okay, have to. Go to Luke, and we go to Marcus, my baby, some minutes. If I can find it. This is a fight. Let's quickly go to Mark 4. And start all this, we're going to go on all the different type of seeds that was what cast out right? So, let's go to Mark 4 and 13. And he said unto them, you know not, right, this parable, and how, when will you know all the parables? So sower soweth the words. So the words being sown, and these are they by the wayside, which hear the word, where the word is sown, but when they have heard, Satan cometh immediately and taketh away the word that was sown in their hearts, which is what their minds, right? So that are those that are what? Fall by the wayside. And that's by means of, you could be having this word, then another philosophy can pull you out. Or you hear this word and you're with your woman, and your woman pulls you out of the truth. Because, we need to go. That's those that were on the wayside, right? Where the word is sown, but when have heard, Satan cometh immediately and taketh them away the word that was sown in their hearts. And these are likewise they which were sown on the ground, right? And it says, when they heard the word, immediately received with gladness, which is what? With joy, okay? And have not root in themselves, right? So this is why we've got to be rooted within this truth. Fully rooted within this truth. Okay? And immediately with gladness, so they receive it straight away and have no root in themselves. That's why we want to be rooted in this truth, rooted in Yahweh Shai, right? Strong like this tree, right? And you're rooted through what? The doctrine and through faith. It begins with faith, right? And have no root in themselves, and endure for but for a time. They endure for a little while, right? When things are going well. Afterwards, when affliction or persecution, right? So when they're afflicted, and when they suffer some persecution, arise for the word's sake, immediately, instantly, they are offended. So you've got those that go through things, go through trials, and they make their trials become an offense, and some fall out, right? That's why when we go through things, so we can be what? Toughened, ultimately, right? Strengthened, okay? And these are they which are sown among the thorns, such as hear the words. And this would represent what? The distractions, okay? And the cares of this world and the deceitfulness of riches and the lust of other things enter in and choke the word, and it becometh unfruitful. This is an individual that gets caught up on what? The distractions, right? And they become what? Unfruitful to the ministry, right? The things of the world, whether it be chasing money, whether it's their job, whether it's their woman, whether it's their children, these are the things that can distract you by what? Pushing the truth, right? And it says, and these are they, like, and choke the word and become if unfruitful. So the things of this world, it can choke the world, it can choke the word, choke it out. And that's what Satan set up to do, to try and choke out this word. But when you see that happening, you've got to fight even more to stay in the spirit, constant battle, right? Go to verse 20. And these are they which are sown on the good ground, right? Such as hear the word and receive it and bring forth fruit, and some 30, some 60, some 100-fold. So that's the whole thing that matters, as long as we're enduring. That's the main thing. As long as we're enduring in this fight and we continue, right, to fight, Yahweh Shavuot would increase you. But when you stop doing that, you just say, oh, what's the point? And you go back into the world, well, how do you expect Yahweh Shavuot to fight for you if you're not fighting for him? So yeah, bear with me just a minute. It is a two-way thing, right? You fight for Yahweh Shavuot, he's going to fight for you. you don't fight for him, he's not going to fight for you. So it goes both ways. It's the effort you put in, you're going to get that back. As the scriptures do say, what a man sows, that's what